Upwatch, Upwatch, the race for top six.
Yeah. Big Sam went to Scouserland and took a point from Big Jorgen. 1-1. You couldn't write this stuff. West Brom at Anfield. I guess beating some baggies at home ain't for everyone. Our point away at Leicester ain't so bad now, is it, United fans? Whatever scenario I played out in my head, I couldn't see Liverpool dropping points against West Brom. Don't doubt Big Sam when he's on survival mode. Samuel Aladici has taken more points at Anfield since 2017 than all the big clubs combined. He is a world-class party pooper. He jammed Salah's hype for at least a week. Firmino went back to social distancing from goals at Anfield. They looked like they thought it was over because they scored early. To be fair, I did too. But then another injury in defence and they couldn't defend set pieces the whole second half. You love to see them fail, but it's not time to get carried away. They ain't gonna give man too many chances like this. Chelsea held Muay Thai strokes from Arsenal. 3-1. Does everybody have Frank's number? If you call, you just get to talk to Frank. He is out here curing the Dennington disease all over the country. He let the team that can't even create a chance hit his team for free, and they should have had way more. Fraudulent Frank. Timid Timo. He really is just a German meat meat. I can't see the difference. Both brainless, both race against the ball, both horrible decision makers. Someone should have warned a brother about this guy. Laka, Shaka, Saka. A pen, a free kick, and a fluke. Sounds like a fairy tale. To be fair, Arsenal getting a win was starting to seem like a fairy tale. These men heard they were about to get taken out of Upwatch and fix their lives. They got their Christmas wish, points, and they moved from 15th all the way to 15th. Safety is on the horizon. Saka, quality. He tormented Chelsea the whole game. This kid is carrying that group of Deadingtons by himself. Martinelli's a big return for them as well. Him and Tierney terrorized that pretender Reece James the whole game. Okay, Arsenal, I see you. You can stay in Upwatch for now. And what hype are the Scousers' neighbours on? The Crips side of the Mersey have been going on behaviours of their own for the last few games. Ancelotti has not only stopped their sliding form, he's got them slapping guys weekly. 4 in the spin in the league and up to 2nd. Jeez! The eyebrows really trying to ting in it. And of course, once again, we're ecstatic that it was Sheffield United holding that work. Then man need to go ASAP. Man's even getting performances out of Gylfi Sigurdsson. You have to respect Ancelotti. I didn't expect them to still be going strong by now. Especially with the injuries they have and that waste man Jordan Pickford in goal. Have no fear though, that Deadington will cost them many points over the season. The battle of the Portuguese ended 1-1. The super defensive one scored in the first minute of this game and tried to protect that goal for 89 minutes. I can't stand Jose Mourinho. He hates this sport and he has taught his team to hate it too. All they do is defend and keep their shape. No shots on target after the 20th minute. Are you fine? He is trying to turn Son into a fullback and everyone else into a centre-back. Real talk, Spurs fans. If you win nothing this season, you know, do a Tottenham. How do you justify the anti-football you man now play? You man got a new stadium to play American football. You man should stick to that full time. At least you used to play ball and you used to make man forget about your lack of trophies. But if this is your new thing, I beg you just go NFL now. That's more Jose's type of game anyway. Wolves, I really like Wolves. But they're not in the running for the top six this season. Just because they don't score enough goals. They are missing Raul Jimenez so badly. But what a player Pedro Neto is. He is such a baller. He carries the ball so well. He makes great decisions and he has stupid technique and slyly. He is stupid fast. He plays like he's way older than 20. He's a real talent. Man City beat a dead Newcastle team 2-0. Blah, blah, blah. Pass, pass, pass. Miss chance, miss chance, miss chance. Cut it back, tap in. This is just a sweaty FIFA team. They never had to come out of first gear to beat the Geordies. João Cancelo was immense for them, though. I really like him. I have from Valencia time. Surprised it took him so long to break into this first team on a regular basis. He is a sick ball carrier and crosser. If there's one thing that the Portuguese know how to make, it's a talented wide player. They are slightly starting to get some form, but City don't look as scary as they did. So, the draw with Leicester did not cost us. We will have to capitalise when the scum dropped points, but it was another decent weekend for us. 21 in 2021 is still on. Come on, United.